Right off the bat, into game number one, Chester playing as Gronk immediately preps up the buff for his own Kimmy. But it does seem like it's not going to be a smooth sailing experience as two members from Cignal Ultra immediately comes in to stop their retreat, or rather stop themselves from getting that buff. They manage to bring Chester down though, but the rest, Kaja as well as Kimmy, is gonna be safe. Well placed Garden Wall coming from Chester, blocks the escape round for Hades, and he's going to be immediately going down. There is no more damage dealer coming from Cignal Ultra. They really shouldn't be continuing with this fight, and it does seem like both sides, they're gonna skip. Renner J finds himself in an unbeatable brawl against the opponent's Marsha, although he did manage to bring his HP all the way down to a sliver of health. Unstoppable force from Jawhead will be just enough to bring yet another man down. Coming in middle lane, the Akai is already down to a really low amount of HP. Unfortunately, the maximum charge coming in from Kimmy did not manage to seal the deal onto Akai. With middle lane inhibitor down, the rest of Team NXP is looking to end the game right into the core, but unfortunately they do not have any more creeps fighting for their cause. Even in the top lane, the only one left is going to be the Ballista, hammering down onto the turret as much as possible. They're looking at the next person into their kill list, and that is going to be Cho. He managed to get himself away, but unfortunately the sacrifice coming in from Akai will be more than enough to save their assassin, or rather their fighter, for the team Cignal Ultra. Ultimately, top lane inhibitor turret still went down, and it doesn't seem like this is going to be a push that they will be able to win for now. They're going to slowly back themselves off away from the opponent's base. The Lord is marching into the impending doom from Cignal Ultra. I don't think that Cignal Ultra will be able to stop this tri-lane push coming in. With Renner J at the top lane, Lord at the middle lane with almost everyone else. Chester tried to push bottom lane just a little bit, but now the Lord focuses all his might, all his force onto the core, and there is absolutely no way that Cignal Ultra will be able to win that one. Valor spots the illegal gathering coming from NXP. They should really observe some social distance, and Chester is going to go in and say absolute no, but apparently it's a trap! It's a trap laid down for Chester, and Chester is going to be the first one going down. The entire team NXP is just fully invested right onto this entire team fight. The Tempest of Blaze will be activated, but unfortunately nothing much will be made apparent. The whole team is now trying to get themselves away as soon as possible. Ling vaulting from wall to wall, and Atlas trying to get himself away from all of that. In the meantime, the entire team of Cignal Ultra, including Hades, continues the pursuit right onto Atlas, and that is gonna be another man down. Cignal Ultra is looking pretty healthy so far. More illegal gathering can be observed at the bottom lane as the entire team of NXP immediately plunged all of their firepower onto Kaja. They did manage to bring him down though, but unfortunately not Marsha. NXP has put three eggs into one basket as they really want to get the gank on right onto Kufra. A really good flicker comes from Blank though, but Renner J came in right on time with the Way of the Dragon to push him away from where his escape route is supposed to be. The entire team of NXP seems to find themselves in a small sort of a little trap. The rest of four men of NXP manage to get themselves away and into the turret, but unfortunately Atlas is going to go down. The control of the map is going to be submitted away to Cignal Ultra. Doesn't seem like things is going to be good, but Atlas initiates Fatal Links onto the entire team of Cignal Ultra, and unfortunately Claude is going to be the first victim in their role. It's literally a death roll coming in. Imba DJ is going to be the next one in the kill list, and Renner J from the other side really wants to catch up onto Kaja, but unfortunately he has to give up that pursuit and gonna go for the Kufra next. H2O trying to go for more kills, and there we go! Final hit onto Kufra is more than enough to get their push on in the middle lane. The Atlas though, he's still at the top lane and he doesn't really want to put himself into the opponent's shoes just yet. With four men just enough to push down the middle lane, this is more than enough to be honest. As you can see from all of the damage, the Wave of Dragon coming from Energy just gonna be immediately pushing the Kaja away, and the Tempest of Blaze gets on to Kaja, and immediately like that, it is going to be a easy wipeout for NXP. But after observing, NXP hides in the brush and says, let's set up a trap. Cignal Ultra also says, let's set up a trap. But who's the one that's really got trapped after all? The entire team fight coming in from clashes from 5 men to 4 men is going to end with Kufra being the first one going down. And what's gonna happen next? That doesn't seem like it's going to be good after all. There's no fatal links whatsoever, but we can observe the Tempest of Blaze coming from H2O trying to get himself away, but unfortunately here comes the Blank to do it. Coming in from Hades, bringing 2 men down. MB is gonna be the last one remaining coming in from the entire team of NXP. But what's the problem here? Renner J playing as Cho, is going to go for the back door, pushing in from the middle lane, but unfortunately the Divine Judgment is just going to be lucky though, and just one more hit! And that is not enough! Cignal Ultra managed to stop the push coming from NXP, and they have the upper hand advantage, pushing in from the bottom lane as well as the middle lane. They can buy more time. What's gonna happen now? With 4 seconds left on the Chester's death timer, they have a Ballista, they have a Mage. Will they be able to close this game out? That's the main question. Chester just dives right in. Hades doesn't care at all! And he immediately locks down onto the core. And ladies and gentlemen, we have the next game down. Blank charges up, the Tyrant's Revenge jumps right onto H2O with the bouncing ball, making sure that H2O is unable to get himself away. And that stays true, as Karrion's gonna be the first one to go down, but with the wild charge coming from Chester, he did manage to deal a significant amount of damage coming from Cignal Ultra though, but it is not enough. Great Guardian Wall, but it does seem like DJ managed to get himself away with just a single easy dash. DJ and Hades are gonna find themselves in quite a pinch in a few seconds time, and DJ melting down like a hot knife through butter. And Hades, well, he did manage to get himself away thanks to the small little Guardian Barrier from Chester. The turtle is going to fall to the hands of Hades, and now he even managed to get a kill onto Chester. That's not all. Dustin is just going to go straight in for the Blazing Duel, managing to get a kill right on Renegade. And is he going to stop anytime soon? Doesn't seem so. Tusjin as well as him managed to go for the push and getting a subsequent kill on top of MB as well. The Lord marches in through the middle lane. The entire team of Cignal Ultra is looking to go for objectives. As you can see, Natalia as well as Hades are just slowly making their way down to the bottom lane, and the rest of Cignal Ultra in the middle lane, they're not really caring anything about the opponent's heroes. They just want to bring the Tyrant down. Bottom lane, Tyrant is down. Middle lane, Tyrant is almost down. Tyrant's Revenge, Tyrant's Rage, landing it all onto NXP, but only onto Jawhead. They don't care about heroes. They only care about Tyrants. But of course, the consolation prize came in form of getting a kill onto Jawhead as well. With 3 inhibitor turrets down, Cignal Ultra is looking at a grand opening right over here, even with the Blazing Duet coming from Hades with a double kill right on top of the heads, or make that a triple kill with an eventual wipeout. Cignal Ultra has gotten themselves with game number 2. I would like to add on that for this game, both sides have pretty impressive lineup. And speaking of impressive lineup, we're gonna definitely be able to see impressive gameplay as well. The Tempest of Blaze coming from Hades is gonna be the one that brings down the Kimmy. MB is going to go down as well. That is double kill coming in from Hades in the form of many other factors. Looking at the map, it kind of seems like Cignal Ultra and NXP kind of looks like ants, you know, swallowing around a turtle, trying to get them some turtle soup. But the whole point is that Cignal Ultra has gotten the control of the river. They've managed to bring the turtle down. Doesn't seem like they're going to stop there anytime soon. Hades trying to go in and trying to get a kill on the H2O with the Tempest of Blaze. He immediately managed to take a quick work on top of that. The entire team of NXP is trying to go for a counter attack with a counter info activated. Rhea definitely going to have a lot of survivability. He's still alive though. And the Divine Judgment coming from Tusjin immediately managed to bring that more of NXP players down. Tyrant's Rage, Tyrant's Revenge going to be landing right on top of Cignal Ultra, and this is slowly becoming the defeat of Cignal Ultra. They managed to bring down the turtle, yes, but the more aggressive that they are, NXP returns with their aggression from their end. This is not wise. Cignal Ultra, they actually don't have a lot of information as to where TNXP really is. They only have 3 men fighting against 5. Make that 4 men fighting against 5. But it doesn't seem like they're still making it out alive. The Tempest of Blaze making so much deal of a damage. 3 men down despite the fact that it was only a 4v5. NXP have got their back against the wall. Cignal Ultra finds a grand opportunity to push into the opponent's base because 2 men is already down, but Rhea completely out of position. Activates Quadrant Inferno. He's still alive. He's not going down anytime soon. But the thing is, Kimmy is now back in the base and he's going to be fighting for his team. The entire team coming in from NXP, they are ready for an eventual comeback. And Cignal Ultra finds themselves in a bad situation, and they know. Cignal Ultra really wants to capitalize the fact that MB is still down without the presence of Jawhead. It's gonna make a very big difference, and Blank is gonna go in for the initiate real soon, charging up the force of nature, but it does seem like he's not gonna release that. The Guardian Wall has been used. It's great for the initiation onto Kufra. Even with a Divine Judgment, he's just going to wriggle him out, and he's gonna be the first man down. The Lord slowly approaches, coming from top lane, and the rest of the team is just gonna be focusing down on the core as soon as possible. The rest of the team coming from NXP, they are unable to stop the frontal push coming from Cignal Ultra. And ladies and gentlemen, Cignal Ultra is your MLI representative for Philippines.